Hello everybody and welcome once again to Running Red, the hardcore questing mod back from Gideon Seymour. It's night time, but I don't think that matters for what I want to show today. The first thing I want to show is, let's have a look, what have I got here? So I've got my air sigil boots, that's the fast falling ones, just normal bound chest plate with void sigil protection, so on and so forth. So what I want to do is to show you the protection on the lava. This here signal of elementary affinity will, when enabled, will protect you from several things. This is actually one it will protect you from. Let's get out of it if I can. This, oh, whew. Get to the water. So that demonstrates it without it being turned on. Let's turn it on and do the same thing. See, this time nothing is happening. All the power has been taken, and I'm not even on fire. It's weird. So the reason I want to demonstrate that is because I want to get some more demon shards. Let's take these two stones here. Fill up these two. I don't need that anymore. And to get some demon shards, we need to place things on here. So elementary device. Items. So let's vote. Here I've got incendium, and the recipe for incendium is 2 blaze powders, 1 bucket of lava, netherite, and a simple catalyst. Fairly straightforward. We need 6. So that's what we'll do, is we'll put 6 of these down here, and what this demon will do is we'll set you on fire. That's okay. We've now got fire protection, so we don't care about being set on fire. It also does some inhibit. They all seem to give you inhibit. Okay, now let's put the master blood orb in the middle. Move out of the way a little bit. Oh, I need to get my sword ready, don't I? Let's get my sword ready. Right, he's ready. And now he'll start to attack us. And here we are, all we just have to do is just hit him. He keeps coming to us, which is great. Oops, where's he gone to now? He's behind me. I should wait a little bit. Ooh. There he is. He's now gone. And dropped him a demon shard. Now, I want to do the same thing for Aquilus. Now Aquilus basically tries to drown you. So we'll do this. Funny, isn't it? We've got water protection again from the same sigil. In fact, I shall demonstrate that just before I put the last one of these down. Let's go and jump in our pool. In fact, I might as well get some food into myself as per normal. What seems to be a necessary thing to do, and here we are. As you'll see, I'm not drowning, and the bubbles are not going down. So if I press E to have a look at myself, I've got water breathing and fire resistance, so no problem. We should not have a problem with getting Aquilus. So now for the last one, and the demon will start. Get the thing prepared. This, it just goes round the circle till the last one, which is now, and then manifests the demon. And here we have it, it's a blue one. Where's he gone to? Trying to get behind me all the time. His health goes down reasonably fast with the bound sword. There he is. Now he's dropped this demon shard. So I've now got 2 demon shards. The last one I'm going to demonstrate is Terra. Now Terra's a little bit more difficult. I don't have any special protection for that, so I'm going to use a notch apple to protect me from this one. So we'll just go around the plinths again, putting on Terra. I'll show you the recipes for these in a minute. They're fairly straightforward. Now we need to notch apple. We get her prepared. And it's the same thing with this one. This time he does actually damage you if he gets near enough. Where's he gone to? There he is. But of course, with the protection of the regen, I shouldn't have a problem with him. There he is. Gone. And I've got my third demon shard. Okay. So you'll see that basically I've took no damage. As far as I can see, got three demon shards. I'll turn off this now, and in a minute or two these particle effects will disappear as the regen and stuff wears off. So what have we got here? 4 minutes I've got to wait for resistance. And what I want to do with this, at least one of these, I want to make another Archmage's orb, pillar orb. So let's take one of these, put that into the hopper. Take out the existing orb and put that back into the hopper and get out of the way so the mobs can carry on spawning. But I must admit, this rain muffler is fantastic. I cannot hear it at all. The other thing I want to do while that's sort of cooking is I would like to do a bit of unbinding. So if we let's get my master ritual stone. Well, let's put it, say, down here, for example. And we'll probably need to remove a few of these torches for the time being, because they'll probably be in the way. And the one I want to pick is, let's have a look, what have we got here? Let's take these stones here and this one. Now we need to shift right click it until we get to the Ritual of Unbinding. That should be the one after binding, which it is. So let's simply click this and get onto the Master Ritual Stone. And I'm hoping that the torches are not in the way of this. They don't look as though they are good. That looks complete. Fantastic. And the idea, what I would like to do with this, is to put on some of our these weapons we've got, or armour, and disassemble them back to the filled sockets and the other components. So at the moment I've basically got three. So for example, I've got these boots here, which I probably could do, and I've got a helmet, so we'll take a helmet. And what I want to do with this is to disassemble it and then put it back with other protections into it. So now let's move that out of the way and let's put the helmet here. Oh, went on. Let's put the helmet down here. I need to get as well, I don't need my jetpack at the moment, I need the awakened orb or the weak activation crystal, it doesn't matter which one. So let's simply press, make sure I've got my Sigil of Magnetism turned off, which I have. But I'll keep it in my hotbar so I can see it. Let's see if we can get this onto here first of all. If I can, that'd be great. And right click. And that's fairly quick. And I get five filled sockets. So what I can now do is actually, what I will do first of all is to check this area by pressing F7, making sure that we don't have any lit up bits. I know we have some actually on the top of these things. So let's just take my jetpack and put my jetpack back on again. I guess you see there's quite a few here. So let's put a few torches in its place. Don't need that again. Great. And probably they should, all of these should in fact be torched, so to speak. And we obviously need another one down here, so it looks like a good place. Yes. any more? No. They don't. The torches do not seem to interfere with the rituals. Okay, good. Turn off the jetpack. I would also like to do the. What else have I got in my inventory here? Devilish chestplate. And a pair of boots. Actually, the boots are okay. We could also do this one as well. Let's put that on here. Got it on, that's amazing. Right click. I got hit by lightning that time. But I did get my things back again. Put the fires out. Don't need to really. They'll go out by themselves. Let's go back over here now, and that Archmage's orb should be made. Looks like it is. Because we're going to need a bit of this. Take this one out. So that's the joined one. What I would like to make is something a bit nasty in terms of weaponry. And I would also like to make some more armour. So what I would like to do is to make another helmet, and this time I'd like to put in it two sigils. So what I want to do is first lay down the armour pattern. It's going to do a helmet pattern. Oops, wrong place. Let's just dig it up. So this time, so what I would like to do is to put, first of all, I'll put a demon shard in here. That's one of the reasons for these. Like that. And then I would like a water sigil and a lava sigil. And that will give me the same two protections as the Sigil of Infinity. This one, Elementary Affinity. So let's put that one in here. Come out of the way and right click this. Now I have a new helmet, look at it, with two slots. And that's what the demon shard's all about, really. Right click that and you can see my protections and right up again. Now, was there anything I forgot to do last quest, by the way? Let me just check my quest book. I haven't looked at that for a few little while. Okay, we've got the usual quest here. Let's claim that one. Let's open up the bag. Got some bread and some apples. Let's put those into here. Let's throw away the aubrey bushes. We don't need our inventory space filled up with junk, do we? Now let's double check the quest book again. That was done. Demolition Lovers. One quest available for completion. And that's here. We've got this one we can do is repeatable. Quest and cemetery drive where we got to go to this place, right? And that's obviously to do with this teleporter here. I've got a diamond, of course, as well. Put the diamond away. Now, what I'd like to make is an energy bazooka. So that's the upgraded version of the energy blaster, and it's quite effective. And I shall demonstrate that. So let's have a look at the recipe for the Energy Bazooka. So we need two Crepitus, two diamonds, one Mast Armitage Blood Orb, one Energy Blaster, and one Weak Blood Shard. Okay, two diamonds, we've got one in there, we need another one. Oh, they were there, weren't they? Let's just have a quick look at the position, don't they not? We put that in the middle, put the orb here. We need another diamond, which we'll get from the witchery chest, and a weak blood shard, and some crepitus, which we'll have to make. Oh, and the recipes for the other ones, by the way, were Crystallis Terra. That was dirt, obsidian, and sand. That's actually probably the cheapest of the recipes. It was incendium, that one which I showed you already, the two blaze rod, blaze powders, bucket of lava, and netherrack. And the third one was Aquilus, we did before. Oh yes, we know Aquilus was the one, wasn't it? So that's one ink sac, which is actually fairly cheap, three bottles of water, and the simple catalyst. Six of those was the one that produced. That's probably the easiest one to do, but fires is just good, which was this one. So now we need to make some crepitus. I'm not sure what the recipe for that is. So we need two gunpowder and cobblestone and a simple catalyst. Okay, that is very easy. We'll take three of each. We'll make three of these. I'd like to make one extra just so I know the recipe or what I've used it for. So we need six of those, and we need six gunpowder. Bones. Actually, anything to do with not having bottles is fairly straightforward. Oh, something's happening. I don't want it to yet. Let's take that. Ah, sand. Damn. Didn't want to make sand. Let's put the simple catalysts in. And the master blood orb will do. Right, I'm going to have to get some more gunpowder and. Yes, I'm going to get some more gunpowder and some cobblestone. Actually, have I got any cobblestone in here? Yes, I have. Gunpowder, I also have. Okay. Oh, I don't need gunpowder, I just need. Oh, yes, I do. So now I have three crepitus. So here we go, let's finish this off now. Oh, I didn't get my diamonds, never mind, I'll go and get the diamond in a second. Let's put that in this chest here just to keep a record and get a diamond from the witch's chest. Oh, this one. Oh, we need the weak blood shard, didn't we? That was the last element of this. We've got eight of those in here. Plenty of weak blood shards actually are also in the other chest. And that goes at the bottom end here. So now here we get this energy bazooka. And I don't lose my armature's blood orb, which is actually great as well. Put that over here. So I'll get rid of this gunpowder. I don't need that. So a quick sort. Can I sort it here? No. Right, I've got another demon shard, which I'm not sure what I'm going to do with yet. And sand. Actually, let's put the sand in here. I've got space. And the other stuff we'll put back over here, because we're not going to use those for the time being. Always keep that with me. Air sigil I will need. Right, and what I'm going to do is to demonstrate this energy bazooka F. Yes, that's working good. Turn him off when I get into the portal. Have a quick look in here, see how many. I got another three wither skeleton skulls. Lots of junk. I still haven't brought my trash can over here, so let's go and fly over here. Oops, don't want to throw my quest book away. I always do that. Instead of pressing W, I'm pressing Q. Have I clicked this to mount my network? Not yet. Well, let's just try firing it. Oh, I've got to activate it. Shift click. And it throws you a long way back. But you can see it does a lot of damage. Let's try that again. I missed it. She doesn't fire straight away. Oh, this to begin. I'm not sure what the reload time of it is. Let's try again. That time up. That was a little bit more effective. Zombie pigmen are going to get bit pissed with me, never mind. I wonder if that hurts me. Right, here we go. I should put a sigil on, shouldn't I? Because anything around here will then get collected. This uses actually quite a surprisingly large amount of. Oh, missed. Tell you what we'll do. We'll get the arrows out as well, just in case. I'm glad he's not a very good shot like I am. There he goes. It seems to do a reasonable amount of clearing, doesn't it? Let's have a. But it certainly does a lot of firing after that. Right. I think that's probably enough of the demonstrations of that. It's not obviously the best way to get blaze rods, but it's certainly a good way of clearing away mobs. What I should also check is how much it uses from your network, your LP. I think it's like 200k. Let's have a quick look. Well, let's turn that off now. Let's give it one shot. So that is. Oh, it's going up all the time because of the mobs in the spawner. So let's say that. Shoot that boy. Oops, it really does throw you back. And then check it again. Let's have a look. Does it tell me? Well, it looks like about 200k. It's difficult to say. Let's turn off the jetpack and go back. Right, I think that it's. You see, now I've got this on because I've got this helmet in place. It's probably time to go and do this last quest. I'm assuming it's the last quest. What have I got here? Flight potion, one swig, 2.4 minutes. Maybe I take one of these before I start this mission, and I will leave in the bound chest plates with the devilish protection. What else do we have in here? We don't need this sigil anymore. See, I made some extra water and lava sigils from last time. I probably will need this sigil of magnetism. I don't need these. I won't need the dagger of sacrifice. I don't think I don't have any altars there. But I did manage to pick up 7 blaze rods. That's quite a high number. I'm not sure where all of those came from. Right. Am I prepared? Nearly. I'm not sure I'd need my divination signal, but I will need my air sigil. Nearly always need it. Right. I won't need my activation crystal. So let's go for it. Are we ready? Oh. And here we come at some portal. Teleporter frames around a teleporter from Mechanis, which is fairly straightforward. So we have a Disenchanted, which I think is a song by Chemical Romance, and on the side here, we have all of the mods that which have been added to this pack, of course. The order of these is just looks like it's alphabetical. I won't look at all of those. Some mobs around. Iron chests, we'll use those a lot. Jaded blood, I'm not sure what that one does. Logistic pipes, I don't think we've used at all. Mine factory loaded, yes, certainly. Natura, well, that's doesn't really give you. Not enough items. Not enough keys. I don't know what that does. Obsidian pressure plates. There's a lot of mod packs in there. Portal gun, statuses, div carts. They didn't do any of that either. Okay. And here we are. The end. Let's go into this and see what happens. So, we've come into a little room. Now I need to turn the sound down a bit on my earpiece anyway. And we need to get out of here. So, oops, what was happening there? Oh, I'm being attacked already. Wow. Let's get this I've got plenty of those. Let's drink one of these. I'll start flying, right. So, we've got an baby ender dragon to deal with. I'm going to try this, but I don't think it's going to work very well. So let's go and deal with the crystals to start with. Maybe the burnout's better. There he is. I don't think I can shoot him with this energy blaster. It's probably too slow. Go and get another one of these crystals before. Missed it. Maybe it's easier with a sword. Now, where is he? And where's the next one? Well, that's one over here. These are around about. It's coming near it, so let's try again. There he is. Now he's maybe poisoned or something. I'll tell you what we'll do. Well, it's a notch apple. Two. He's obviously flying off to get some regen, I guess. Ah, there we go. Another one. Oh, another two. I should be able to do this faster than this. It's taking me a while. Oh. Somebody died. Where has he gone to? Over there. Another one over here. If I get this right, I can travel much faster with a lava crystal. Another one. Doesn't help with everything painting in so slowly. Oh, plenty of these things around. Fortunately, the Ender Dragon does help, even if it's just a baby. Oh, can't get it. Oh yeah. What I'm going to do is I'm going to wait for him to come to me. Oops, didn't mean to do that, it was too fast. That's also too fast. I don't think he's got any more regen. Here he comes. Would be good if I could get him with this bazooka thing. I'd have to wait for him to get close before I can use that, isn't it? Because it's too slow, the transporting of this. Oh, missed him again. I haven't got forever, I've got... because my flight potion won't last forever. I'm getting very many hits on him at the moment. Try the sword again. No, it's too far away, isn't it? At least he keeps coming at me. Now, I missed him. Maybe we were up too high. does like shooting his maybe we're not high enough now. Oh, I got him. Surprising shot. Another one. A bit slow sometimes, so it doesn't help. Just a quick look at my inventory. Ah, 10 minutes, fine. Oh, he's actually very close. Let's get him. I should have got blindness. I don't know why. I don't know where I am. There he is. I don't think that's very effective against him at all, so we'll have to stick to the bow and arrow. I ain't sure I've got enough arrows for him to that, for that matter. So I'll have to be a bit more careful with my arrows. Oh, I really don't have enough arrows for him. Or more. I hit him anyway. So now I've got to go and attack him in the old-fashioned way. It's with a sword. If I can get to him. That's interesting. Well, these things, bats. But look, 7 minutes, and no arrows. That's crazy. He's almost gone. If I could hit him with this thing. Don't even know where he is. Where has he gone to? Oh, there he is. I think he is taking damage when I do that. Yeah, the recharge time is quite long. Shame I haven't got any more arrows. can't actually get near to him with my... This is going on far too long as a fight. Oh, I did get him in the sword. Good. Oh, one more hit and he'll be gone. There we go. Got him at last. That was hard work. It didn't help for having not enough. Still not signal at the moment. Oh, I can't see. Oh, these bats here. Never seen those before. Fairly easy to deal with, I guess, like most bats. Just whack her with your sword. Sword, of course, has now got to look for. There's plenty of XP down here. Just walk around and see what I pick up. And plenty of draconium or something like it. Ooh, another hive. And I haven't... Oh no, not another hive. The ender hive. That one we could use, possibly. What else have we got around here? Ender pulse, of course. A good supply of ender pulse. What have we got here? So, an ender plant. Do we have a demon heart or anything like that? Or does that not exist in this mod pack? Oh, dragon essence. I've got plenty of dragon essence. The yellow heart. Well, I'm sorry, this has been a bit of a longer episode than it should have been, because I'm not very good at fighting in Minecraft, as you have seen. But I don't have a scoop with me. Let me just check my... I've still got 3 minutes light. In fact, I don't need my void sigil with me anymore. So, next thing to do is to find the way to get back. Where is the portal? Ah, here we are. Is there anything else I would like to collect on them here? Plenty more XP down here. That's it. Okay. So, the end. So I can let the titles go through, or I simply think I can press space, in case you haven't seen those before, that is, and bypass them. Or was it escape I have to press? Yes, escape. And then we come back. Back at home with everything we've got from the previous one. Next time I'm going to have to do any more fighting. I'm not going to do that. Let's have a look at our quest book now. We've got that one, of course. Visited. Oh, I've got to die. Okay. Let's do that. Let's first of all put all my stuff in this chest. In fact, what I probably should do is to do that next time. Where did the obsidian come from? Hopefully I don't have to die in the end to prove myself, as it were. Okay, let's get rid of this stuff. Now I should be completely empty with no inventory. That's the intention. And then let's simply die. I suppose the easiest way of doing that is like this. Okay, let's respawn. Let's go back and get the quest book. Bit of a daft thing, this one, isn't it? Let's see if that actually succeeded in finishing the quest off. You died one time. Okay. So it should say completed. No rewards. That's it. Well, I hope you enjoyed this episode. I haven't quite finished. There are a few things I'd like to do, especially with witchery. So maybe I'll finish that another time. Until then, bye for now.